Alright, this is a very interesting question. Is this really equal to 0? And I will tell you yes, because on how this expression is written. If it's written like this, what we mean is we are trying to do this inside out, like this. So let me show you that this right here is indeed equal to 0 computationally. And I'll show you guys the concept behind why this is equal to 0. And I know what you guys are thinking. Isn't this the same as the integral going from negative infinity to positive infinity of x dx? Well, I will tell you, no, they are not equal. But really, let's talk about this first. Do this inside out. So right here, we will get the limit as a going to infinity of, integrating this, we get 1/2 and then x squared, and we go from negative a to a. All right, put the numbers in and all that. So we have the limit as a going to infinity. Now, as you can see, this right here is really just the same as a squared. And then we have the 1/2. So we have 1/2 a squared minus 1/2 a squared. So the inside, if you work this out, we get 0. So this is asking, what's the limit as a approaching infinity of 0? And that's for sure equal to 0. And then we are done. Done. All right, now. What if we have the question written down like this, the integral going from negative infinity to infinity of x dx? This is an improper integral that has two trouble places, negative infinity and also positive infinity. We cannot handle both of them at the same time. So what we do is we separate them. We are going to rewrite this as the integral going from negative infinity to some number, like a cutoff number. Let's use 0. If you want to put down 17 or pi, be my guest, but we'll use 0. And then we are going to pick this up from 0, and then we go to infinity. Right, so that would be the proper way to take care of this kind of improper integral. So what does this mean though? Well, to handle improper integral with the infinity, we take the limit as well. So for the red one here, we will take the limit. And because it's on the bottom here, so let me use a, because usually we have the integral going from a to b. So we have a going to negative infinity, and then we are looking at the integral going from a to 0 of x dx. And then we will have to combine this with the other part. And then that's the limit as b. We cannot use a anymore. That's the key. We use the a right here already. For this one, let's use b going to infinity, and then 0 to b x dx. And now let's just work this out. This right here, of course, do this inside out, we'll still take the limit on the outside. Again, we will just get 1/2 x squared, and then we will have to go from a to 0, like so. And let's just focus on this first, yeah? So this will give us the limit as a going to negative infinity. Putting 0 is just 0, and then putting the a, so we will have a minus right here first, and then putting a, we will have 1/2 a squared. Then we are going to take the limit as a going to negative infinity. When you square that, it's positive infinity, but here's a negative. So all in all, this right here will give us negative infinity, all right? Which diverges. If you just have this improper integral by itself, it diverges, and then we are done. And now let's take a look at this. In fact, you don't even have to. If you are trying to answer this question, once you get one part being the divergent, you are done. You can just say the whole thing diverges. But I know you guys will have some questions with this, because it will give you positive infinity. So you might be wondering, yes, this right here is negative infinity, and this is positive infinity. It's indeterminate, yes, but can we do any kind of work to simplify it? No. Because once we've broken this down into two integrals, this is like a limit question on its own. Likewise, this is another separate limit question on its own. If this right here diverges, which it did, the whole thing is ruined. You don't even have to worry about what this is. This negative infinity, there's no way for you to kind of draw any connection with this right here. So the answer for this question right here is just the integral does not converge. So we say it diverges. So what exactly is going on between these two parts? Let me show you. You see how we go from negative a to a? That's symmetric. So if you look at the picture, we are talking about just x, so it's like this. All right, let's say a is somewhere right here. So that would be negative a, and then we will have to make sure we have the same space, yeah? Same amount right here, that would be a. Of course, this part is going to be having the same area as that. So I'll just color this part and color that part. Imagine if you end up with negative infinity here from the integral because it's below the x-axis. Guess what? That infinity will cancel with this infinity completely and you end up with zero. Because it's always symmetrical based on how this is written. But if you're taking a look right here, this right here, we have negative infinity to zero, but where is negative infinity? It's all the way to the left, right? So let me just say maybe somewhere right here, just somewhere right here. This is the negative infinity with the a right here, a right here. So you have this part right here, and then we end up with negative infinity. But for this part, is it going to be the same thing as that earlier? We have this is a. Do we do this right here to be the b? No, it's not symmetrical anymore. Not necessary. It could be, but we don't know. The b right here can be maybe just right here. And imagine if the b is big enough, of course, you end up with past infinity. And in that case, just look at this picture as an idea, right? This negative infinity is so much bigger in terms of the size compared to this past infinity. And when you combine them, maybe the final result is negative infinity. But if the b right here is actually somewhere here, then in that case, the blue infinity is so much bigger than that red negative infinity. When you combine them, maybe the result is past infinity. The key is this and that are not symmetric. That's why this integral does not converge. That's the key. So, it's complicated. Final question is, are there any connections between this and that though? And the answer is yes. This is the final touch. If today you want to say the integral going from negative infinity to past infinity of x dx is equal to zero, well, this is wrong, right? This is wrong because I just showed you guys that this integral diverges, so you cannot say that's equal to zero. However, we do have a way to assign values to divergent integrals, and that's called the Cauchy principle value. So in order to make this true, right here above the equal sign, just put down PV. The principal value of this integral is equal to zero, meaning we are assigning this value to that divergent integral. And how do we come with the zero? By doing that.